Loveships Limited, LSL, is a UK business founded to exploit the gift that nature provides us with for buoyancy from the atmosphere, enabling flotation in the air. This natural effect was first used by people thousands of years ago for small floating lanterns in the sky, a delight to behold that continues today. It's a difficult concept for people to understand because the effect on us is so small and doesn't need power to function. It just occurs. In water, the effect is obvious, and Archimedes' principle is applied in the same way. Flotation aids like life vests are often used to help people float in water. Well, that's what aerostats do to help people float in the atmosphere. They are just necessarily very big, exceptionally light, much lighter than air, so LTA, soft flotation aids. Introducing LSL. Here at LSL, we wish to enable the benefits of atmospheric flotation in compatible ways, while minimizing any harm to the environment. We believe aircraft generally should be that way. After all, our atmosphere is a precious thing that is essential to all life on Earth. We believe that air currents are a natural way for conveyance that should be used as the main method for air transport instead of jet aircraft. Aeroplanes, pushing through the air with their thirsty power plants, discharge huge quantities of exhaust products every day, gobbling up finite oil resources and leaving problems for generations to come. We would like to enable flotation methods that mainly harness the atmosphere. We also believe that more efficient low-energy methods for locomotion should be used, and that the energy needed to power things should be from replenishable sources, like solar energy. Historians tell us that people first took to the air in 1783 with the Montgolfier brothers leading the show with their hot air aerostat, closely followed by Professor Charles and Robert in a much smaller hydrogen-filled balloon. Both methods still are popular today and considered to be ways for environmentally friendly flight. Whilst hot air is useful, adopted by most balloon businesses, we are mainly interested in less common but more efficient LTA gas-filled aerostat methods, believed to be the better way for long-endurance aircraft. Our goal is to provide products and services for niche markets concerning fabric structures and LTA aircraft with new and better capabilities than those which exist today. Airships. Airships are a main objective. They are dirigible balloons which first began to appear in the 19th century, but by 1940 it was game over for huge zeppelins and the like, leaving just smaller types based on non-rigid aerostat principles. The reasons the giant airships were abandoned include vulnerability as war aircraft, inability to compete with aeroplanes, slow and costly to produce, difficult to manage at ground level, fragility. When their gas cells were filled with hydrogen, a recipe for disaster. On the other hand, smaller, non-rigid types were found to be effective and reliable in both world wars, shepherding ship convoys against submarine attacks. They also found some uses for commercial purposes, like Goodyear's promotional airships fleet. However, it largely was game over for them as well by 1960, mainly due to powerful USA lobby groups who wanted aeroplanes instead. The know-how from experience thus was lost as people who previously worked in the industry died. The return of airships. When airships reappeared in the 1970s and 1980s, it was with people who had interest and perhaps knowledge from history books, but with little actual know-how from experience of airships. The rebirth also was in an age with new materials and systems, but then with severe established aircraft regulations to contend with. What followed was a short-lived revival lasting 40 or so years, for mainly traditional non-rigid airships without overcoming the foibles that caused them to be phased out before. Today, the industry is back on its heels needing better ways to follow, where more of the same is unlikely to succeed. We believe it needs new steady ways to break the cycle and overcome the shortcomings. We thus still believe that airships with their natural long endurance capability are needed, due to being the only viable way for some purposes, which we plan to enable, such as aerial cranes for loads more than helicopters will ever manage, heavy lift transporters in regions that otherwise are poorly served by other methods, aerial platforms that remain reliably aloft for exceptionally long periods, aerial cruisers for people to enjoy affordable, environmentally friendly air travel, cost-effective LTA rovers, manned and or unmanned, for patrol anywhere, late 20th century airship technology. Roger Munk, the first person in the late 20th century to develop commercial airships, found that there was a need for more reliable ways to hold them still when moored, and operate them with ground equipment to overcome their inherited poor weather behavior. He thus recognized need for change and, from seeing models flying that were able to develop more aerodynamic lift over their aerostats than conventional forms, plus consideration of hovercraft skirts that could work in reverse, like limpets, thought he had solutions, then introducing what were called hybrid airships. Unfortunately, what's evident from the various versions promoted since he died is that they increase complexity. The technology is immature. They're being marketed for unsuitable purposes. Information about them is misleading. They need development of unavailable infrastructure and mechanical handling methods. They have high power needs. To enable airships that overcome the shortcomings of unidirectional types and provide the capability for the services needed more easily, LSL went back to basics for an alternative way to make balloons dirigible with reduced air resistance without losing or compromising their inherent omnidirectional capability. We found that by squashing them into alternative discus form, lenticular, with reduced aerodynamic resistance resulted in several benefits. Better efficiency as a gas container. Greater ability to naturally develop aerodynamic lift. Uniformity of form. Better ability to spread added loads evenly. Can be fixed when moored and hold any heading desired during flight. Scales easily and can be used for additional purposes. Easy to arrange as both a free balloon and airship, switching routinely between these modes. In the parallel aeroplane industry, there came a time when people started looking for alternative aircraft that could ascend and descend vertically with a payload, hold station and heading at any height above a ground point, plus rotate or move sideways with ease. This resulted in the introduction of helicopters, which today are successful aircraft fulfilling many duties that aeroplanes don't suit. They're successful because of their omnidirectional capability. Love ships and 21st century airships. We believe that airships can also be successful this way using discus form aerostats, but for service that extend the capability of helicopters for bigger and heavier payloads with significantly longer endurance and range. It involves parallel development of cycloidal propellers, able to provide rapid response vectored thrust in any direction, and perhaps rotors facilitating heavy lift. However, we believe they're the right way for airships of all types, and an easier way to follow than vectoring screw propellers. These are not an industry standard, as many people mistakenly believe, and require special development for each aircraft. Also needed are ways for 6-degree of freedom control in automated ways. Multi-rotor drones achieve this today in clearly reliable ways. We think the technology isn't difficult to adapt for airship purposes, thus enabling them to enter the Industry 4 world. LSL is working with numerous industry specialists, suppliers and collaborators interested in making lighter-than-air aircraft a reality. We believe there's a good chance for success that will enable the airship industry generally. To find out more about our work and our visions, visit www.loveships.com. Use the contact form to get in touch with us and register your interest.